This is the third presentation of this series. We need to correlate what we see on the visual field with that on the OCT. This will increase our confidence of the diagnosis. This is the famous work of Gerway back in 2000. He showed the anatomical location of the dislocations of the field, the 24 degree of Humphrey field, where are located in relation to the fundus. 2007, Hood et al. Demonstrated the relation between the dislocations and the disc. So these 6 points in the field will get into the disc over these 90 degrees. Then this zone up, and similarly the zone down, will get into the disc along these 40 degrees. As you notice here, we have 3 points, 4 points, 2 points. All this zone will end up here, and the reverse is true for the lower part. Then the remaining part up and remaining part down will get access at this location. Then we are left with 4 dots on the nasal side here. They will end up on the nasal side of the disc. So if you want to check that on the OCT, the 360 degrees of the peripapillary, it is shown up here over 256 degrees. This zone, the mostly affected in glaucoma, is located here, inferior temporal, in this area. So you have to keep an eye always on this area. Next, in frequency of affection, is the upper temporal on this area. This is the same, but with more details here for you to keep in mind. And again, I try to figure out the location of the commonly affected area in the hour section of the OCT. In another paper by Hood et al. In 2013, they gathered patients with field changes. They grouped them depending on the mean deviation, minimal affection, moderate affection between 1.5 mean deviation to 5.5, or higher affection if it's higher than that. They found here, this is the thickness of the ganglion cells, and this is the thickness of the nerve fiber layer. As the field is affected more, the thinning occurs in both the ganglion cell and the retinal nerve fiber layer. And also, they pointed out that changes in the ganglion cells are extremely more common being on the temporal side of the fovea. Later, the same group pointed out to an area called macular vulnerability zone of the disc. This area, when it is affected, they believe that this will be associated with changes in the ganglion cells of the macula. So this is area, when it is included, ganglion cells are also affected in the macula. And this is the vulnerable zone around the disc and is associated with changes in the macular area. So as you notice, ganglion cell changes are on the temporal side of the fovea, and when it is involved, the vulnerability zone around the disc is also involved. Another study showed the same thing back in 2017. So, to sum up, one needs to keep in mind the correlation between the field locations and the peripapillary nerve fiber layer. Also, keep in mind on an area known as macular vulnerability zone, when it is affected around the disc, then the ganglion cells are also affected. Thank you.